This is Dr. Shirish Jebley from ICFAI Business School, Pune. I teach IT and operations courses here in ICFAI Business School, Pune. This is a presentation about marketing business analytics course for 33 sessions, and it's a 3 credit course, and it's going to start from June 2020. So let's start with the contents. First of all, we're going to discuss what is marketing business analytics and what are the course objectives, followed by the session plan. What is the continuous evaluation? How we're going to do that? What will be the methodology for conceptual sessions, which will cover theoretical concepts? What will be the methodology for practical case studies, which forms about 80% of the course? And we will also discuss what will be the group projects in analytics, what will be the process that we're going to follow for forming the groups, and then what will be the steps we're going to follow. And finally, what will be the different components of the online assessments in order to assess the student performance during this course. Okay, let's start with different marketing business analytics. Like any analytics course, this requires variety of marketing data. And this course is all about learning of statistical techniques, which are used to extract actionable insights from the marketing data, which will drive the business results. The business results will be in terms of metrics such as profitability, market share, or product-wise profitability, and so on. The course objectives are defined as follows. To start with, we want to learn more about various sources of data and how to create value for business from this data. This data will be centered around customer, sales, transactions, and various other subtle sources of data. So we're going to learn more. Second is, we will learn alerts or data mining techniques to derive actionable insights from marketing data, how to interpret those results basically. Then we'll learn various analytics techniques and their practical applications. There are statistical techniques which are used in analytics, so we're going to learn those. And finally, we will get hands-on experience in Excel and R as a source. So as a result of this whole 4 objectives, we are also going to have another objective, which is developing the analytical capabilities of the students. Now, the session plan is divided into 33 sessions. So each topic has been given enough time so that there is a proper explanation of the theoretical concepts. And then based on those, we will perform some practicals. So concepts such as simple and multiple regression, then customer-centric marketing models has been given enough time so that we have several variations of different practical case studies covered during these sessions. Moving to the continuous evaluation, we're going to have the midterm, which is going to be for 20%, then online assessment will be for 40%, class participation and attendance will be for 10%, and interim examination for 30%. Now let's discuss the method for conceptual session. So we will start with a recap of the previous session. Then we will spend the first few minutes in discussing what is going to be the session intention. So what are we going to achieve in today's session? We will discuss the concept, theoretical concept, using different examples or applications. We will play one video from the industry so that students can relate to that concept. Again, we will discuss the follow-up concepts related to the main concept with some examples, and we will conduct either a choice poll or a quiz, or we will have interaction over Zoom or the question and answers with the students. And finally, again, we'll do a session recap. We will use online tools such as QuickForce, which has quiz, forum, assignments, page module, book module as a reference. We will use YouTube for playing videos. We are also extensively going to use web references for students to read before the session and after the session. Now, moving to the practical case studies, we will start first of all with a small presentation where there will be the concept such as regression or cluster analysis will be explained in detail. Then the case study discussion will happen. So we are going to share what is the problem first. Then that problem will be solved using Excel or R Studio in the class. Then we will solve after the solution has been demonstrated to the students. We will give them multiple case studies for homework, and those will be placed on QuickForce as a forum. Students will be given a time for submitting back their solution on QuickForce, and then based on those solutions, whether they are timely submissions are happening or not, online assessment will be happening over a period of time. Then we are also going to use analytics group projects where students will first form a group among themselves, or we will use QuickForce for forming the groups. Then the group will define what is, they will identify what is their project. They will define the project goals or objectives. Projects can be selected from variety of different areas, such as doing customer segmentation or market segmentation. They want to predict the customer attrition, or they want to identify high potential customers or customers most likely to buy. So such different cases will be taken by the students. They themselves will define what is the data source, where the data will be coming from. They will decide the suitable analytics technique, apply the technique and analyze the output. And they will document their findings in a report. This report will be submitted in the QuickForce forum, and then they will be given an opportunity over two or three sessions for presenting their entire project journey. And assessment will happen in a either group to faculty session, or maybe it could be even in the classroom, online classroom. Online assessment will have four different components. One will be quiz, which will be conducted from time to time, and individual students must participate in that quiz, and that data will be collected in QuickForce. Assignments will be given using QuickForce, and students will have to complete those individual assignments and submit those in the QuickForce. Forum, mostly for group assignments, we are going to use forum, or sometimes even for individual assignments also, wherever applicable. And of course, analytics group projects will be, the submissions again will happen online using QuickForce. Okay, now there are several books available on the marketing analytics, but we are going to use the first book, which is Marketing Analytics Using Data-Driven Techniques with Microsoft Excel by Wayne Winston. This is the main reference book we are going to follow, but some of the techniques here we are going to also run on R. We can learn in Excel, but we will also use R for running those techniques. And then there are several reference books which are available online as well as in the library. So that's pretty much it. Thank you very much for listening.